I'm calling this segment, "Hey, I also like to listen to music. You like to listen to music too? Hey, I also like to listen to music." Episode 1. So, I have a bunch of vinyl that's just sitting on my shelf that I've been collecting over the last few years. What started as a very modest collection has grown into something that I'm quite proud of. And I decided that it would be fun to just share some of my favorite vinyl records that are in my collection. So I have 10 here that I'd like to show you. In no particular order of favorites, I'm just going to go through them. I'm going to tell you what I like about them. Some of them have some neat packaging. That's partially the reason why they're included, other than just being really great albums in the first place. Just things that I'm really proud to include. So, number one, I picked this up last year when I was living in Springfield. I got Billy Joel's The Stranger, one of my favorite albums just in general. It's got classics such as Moving Out, Anthony's song, Just the Way You Are, Scenes from an Italian Restaurant, Only the Good Die Young, a personal favorite, She's Always the Woman, and a few more. She's Always a Woman is one of my favorite songs of all time. I think it's just one of the greatest songs ever written. There's just something about this album. It's only 9 tracks. But it's the packaging looks fantastic. It's just fun. It's very, I don't know what you want to call it. It's very Billy Joel. If you're into Billy Joel, this is his best album. Disagree with me. Agree with me. No matter what, one of my favorites. Next up, we got an album by the fantastic Father John Misty. This was released in 2016 to rave reviews from a lot of people and from yours truly. I discovered Father John Misty shortly before this album came out, most notably on his David Letterman performance of, oh shoot, what song was that? Born in the USA. His performance of Born in the USA seemed to mystify David Letterman, but it did not mystify me, and I was immediately hooked, and I went back and listened to Fear Fun, which was his first album under the moniker Father John Misty, the wonderful Josh Tillman, that is, I'm talking about, and then he released this album. I was able to pick up this album at a show in Nashville. I drove 6 hours with a friend to Nashville and got to see this show. I'll show this off. It's just clear. It's wonderful. I would at some point love to pick up the deluxe version of this vinyl, which features, you know, a double LP just like this. There's two vinyl records in here. And it's just like 3 different colors all kind of lined up. And it's wonderful. Also, the insert is a pop-out, so that same picture that you saw, it pops out. It's amazing. Next up, one of my favorite albums. When did this album come out? Was this 2011? This was 2010. I did not discover this album until 2016, no, not 2016, maybe 2015, maybe it was 2016, 2015 or 2016, I think it was might have been my senior year of college, High Violet by The National. This also features what I would consider one of my favorite songs ever written, one of the greatest songs ever written, called Lemon World. I love it so much. It's such a great song. This is such a solid album. I could have gotten this in a different color. I think they had it in purple, but I just got it in black. This album came to me at a time where I was discovering quite a variety of genres, you might say. And so kind of this post-punk, beautiful Matt Berninger vocals. It almost like it communicated to me that some monotoned lines can still be expressive, and lower vocal registers can be so rich. And so instead, this really turned the tides in terms of me and how I pursued my own music. And so it really brought a lot to the table for me. And that's one of the reasons it's one of my favorites, other than just being a fantastic album. Next up is another Father John Misty album. This is the deluxe edition of Pure Comedy. This might be my favorite album ever. So the deluxe edition is double LP. It's got different backgrounds, different inserts. So if you put them in, it has a different color. But the base one that's on the actual stuff. So technically, if there was a correct way of doing it, this might be it, right? Having this knight insert in here, like that. Except with pure comedy, Father John Misty on here, right? This was a big album for me in 2017. I bought this album before, I pre-ordered it. And it was just coming off the heels of a I Love You Honey Bear by Father John Misty. I had high expectations for this album because these albums just, they, like any good album, like any album that I'm really into, it expanded my musical taste. It expanded my understanding of the types of sounds and types of writing that I could be capable of. Not that I didn't know that they existed, I just never really identified with them like I did when I discovered Father John Misty. And so if you want to know a lot of my outlook just on politics and life in general, and I share a lot of criticisms that he makes on these albums of the world, it's just, it inspired me so much. So that's one of the reasons. This might be my favorite album ever, just because it had such an effect on me, and I think it gave me a healthier view of life, you know, for someone who is, you know, worried about the state of the world and what's going to come next and how we're going to deal with the next problems. That album definitely did quite a bit for me. Next up, we have the fantastic Pink Moon by Nick Drake. I can't remember when I discovered this album. I can't. But I do know that when I discovered this album, this is a repressing, by the way, because the originals are way too expensive and I'm not that rich. I was probably pretty sad. And this is such a visceral album to me, because it speaks to, at least to me, that there is so much hope in the darkness that he was experiencing when he wrote this album. In contrast to the previous album that he released, this album is pretty stripped back. It is majority just him and his guitar, save for the title track, Pink Moon, which has a little bit of piano in it. Nothing too special about it, at least from a vinyl standpoint, but definitely one of my favorite albums. Favorite lyric off the album is just the entirety of Pink Moon. I saw it written, and I saw it say, Pink Moon is on its way. None of you stand so tall. Pink Moon is going to get you all. And if you want to know, and the reason why, I think it's just the reality of that statement. It's contributes to the visceral nature of this album. Accepting the things that you cannot change, I guess. I need to get more sleeves for my vinyl. I don't have enough sleeves. So if you want to send me money, I don't currently have a way to set that up. See, I got a few more albums here. One of these albums I just got the other day, one of the inspirations for me doing this, because I was just so excited to share it. This was an album I was introduced this year, and that is Hawaii Part 2 by Miracle Musical. A friend of mine introduced me to the very last song on this album, Dream Suite in C Major. And C as in S-E-A, not in C, the letter C. And this is just a multi-discipline, multicultural trip. Like, there's so many influences on this project. Again, another clear one. Got a lot of clear albums. And it just hit me in a way that no other album hit me this year. At least that I listened to. There might be some that might hit me and like go in. But they had a Kickstarter for a vinyl release. Again, it came out originally in 2012. And it's I could not be any happier about this Kickstarter backing. I can't recommend it enough. Especially if you're a fan of the original Hawaii. Like, the place Hawaii, which that's what I think it's a sequel to, part two. This is the island of the place. And then this album. Jeff Buckley's Grace. Goodness gracious. I picked this up, like, early 2017. And I had not long before that had really discovered Jeff Buckley. Nothing really interesting about it. One of the gripping things about this album for me is I had the experience of like finally deciding to listen to Jeff Buckley. People told me so many times before, Logan, you'd really, really, really like Jeff Buckley. And I was like, okay, I better listen to Jeff Buckley. So I put this album on as I was going to bed, because I used to listen to a lot of music before I slept. And I put it on, and as I was snuggled up in the darkness, the first lines of this album is, you're lying in your bed, your blanket is warm. And that was just the setting I needed to hear this in, and then the rest is history. And this album is incredible. Absolutely incredible. Jeff Buckley's vocals are just otherworldly. Absolutely otherworldly. And how it complements his guitar playing and just his presentation overall. He was a beautiful, beautiful man that we lost too early. Not also to mention that we lost Nick Drake. Rip Nick Drake. Very young. All of them very young. Don't die young. Stop dying young. Next up, Sufjan Stevens, Carrie and Lowell. This album is pretty, pretty, pretty special for a number of reasons. 2015 came around, and on my spring break, I went and visited some friends in Oklahoma, and I listened to this album almost exclusively. Probably exclusively. I don't think I listened to anything else like the whole week I was there. I just listened to this album throughout you know, countless times. Obviously, Sufjan Stevens has always been an artist that other artists have looked up to. But I feel like this is him refining everything that he had up to that point and distilling it into something that had quite the weight to it. And when you're dealing with heavy things, there's nothing more therapeutic than writing music. And so take his years and years of experience of songwriting and playing and lyricism and just distill it into this, you know, idea about death and loss and, you know, belief and all this other stuff. And man, it's no wonder this album made it on so many, you know, lists, the top of best of the year list, right? In 2015. Still holds up. It's only a few years out. We're going to 2019, so this album will be turning 4 years old this coming year. And we have one more album. Another contender for one of my favorite albums. And also the oldest album of these 10 albums. And if anybody knows me, or if you've watched some of my other videos, you might know that Frank Sinatra's In the Wee Small Hours is just one of my favorite albums ever. It's incredible. It's a masterclass in unrequited love. It's a masterclass in heartbreak. It's just like anything that you could ever feel getting your heart broken and also and not necessarily putting the blame on anybody else for that, just like the reality of somebody, you know, for whatever reason not loving you back in that way. This album found me at one of those times, but I'm a huge fan of this record in general. I'm a huge fan of the vinyl, particularly because like you get the album artwork and it's so big, and this album artwork is really, really great. Like just the blues and the blacks and the somberness. Like I'd really love to do something like this one day. Like get a picture and then have somebody like paint it, right? And really go hard on it, because this is a really special album. I have a cover of the title track in the Wee Small Hours of the Morning on this channel, so you should check that out. Also, don't smoke cigarettes. They're bad for you, though if you do, I guess that's okay, because I don't like to hate on too many people, and people have their reasons for the things that they do, good or bad. I'm not one to judge. So yeah, those are my 10 favorite albums in my record collection. I have a few others that are of note, and maybe I'll touch on those as I collect some more, and I'll show you more, but these are definitely 10 of my favorites. So what did you think? Do you like some of these albums? Do you know some of the albums? Are you going to check out some of these albums based on my recommendation? Because, man, I can't recommend any of these albums enough. Like, they're all just fantastic records for so many reasons, and I probably missed a million and one reasons why they're all great, but I couldn't encourage people enough to watch these. And this will be my last video of 2018, so see you on the other side, and have a happy new year.